Hello, it's time for your Omnisend updates. This one's pretty straightforward. We've made a bunch of changes across the platform. Some visual, some functional, and most of them are based on stuff you've been asking for. So let's just run through what's new this month. Platform glow up. First up, we've given the platform a bit of a refresh, mainly to make the interface easier to navigate and use. The new sidebar is cleaner and quicker to scan, and you'll notice updated fonts, icons, and colors throughout. Overall, things should feel lighter and more intuitive, especially when you're working on common tasks like editing an email or updating an automation. If you want to try it early, you can switch it on starting May 6th with the beta toggle, and on May 20th, it becomes the default. That's it. No big redesigns, it just works better now. Omnisend AI. The subject line generator is now easier to access. Just click the AI icon or hit the slash key to pull it up. You can now use it inside automation emails, not just campaigns. And after you generate a subject line, you'll automatically get a matching pre-header suggestion too, which saves a bit of brain power. Also, Omnisend AI will now try to match your brand tone based on your web store. So if you're usually casual, it'll write that way. If your brand is more formal, it won't suddenly throw in a "Hey-ya!" with a million emojis out of nowhere. It's subtle, but you'll notice it. Automations. On the automation side, you can now send Wheel of Fortune discount codes by email. Before, they only showed up in an on-site success message, which worked, but wasn't always ideal. Now you can actually email the code to people, which makes it more likely they'll use it. Though quick note, if you're running a welcome automation, make sure you exclude Wheel of Fortune users from that flow. We've linked a quick guide for that down below. Forms. Forms got a small improvement, and bear with me here. You can now have multiple next step buttons in the first step of a multi-step form. It still leads to the same next step, but now you've got more freedom with wording or layout. I swear it makes sense. Audience. In the contact section, you can now customize which columns show up. So if you don't want to see phone number or date added or whatever, you don't have to. Also, contact exports now include on-site activity like page views and clicks, which is useful for GDPR requests or just general context. And when you're tagging contacts, you'll see a full list of existing tags, which should cut down on any unwanted duplicates. Reports. The backend stock report now includes contact level detail. You can click on any product and see exactly who signed up to be notified, including name, email, or phone number, and the date they added themselves to the list. This definitely should help with prioritizing what to restock or just keeping track of who's waiting. Now, over on the e-commerce platform side, if you're using a custom events API, the store health dashboard now shows the success ratio, which should help you troubleshoot faster. And for WooCommerce users on WordPress Multisite, Omnisend now supports that setup. You can now manage multiple stores under the same install without having to install the plugin separately on each site. Deliverability. SMS campaigns got a small but mighty improvement too. The platform now recognizes a wider range of subscribe and unsubscribe messages, like start, stop all, opt out, and many more, especially for the US and Canada. It's mostly a compliance thing, but it also helps keep your SMS lists a little cleaner. Integrations. And finally, two new integrations this month. Zigpoll is now available. You can use it for quick surveys across email, SMS, or your site. It's good for post-purchase feedback if you want to collect data without setting up something complex. And Portable now integrates with Omnisend. It lets you sync your Omnisend data, campaigns, contacts, orders into your data warehouse or analytics tools without writing code. That's it for me. Nothing flashy, just a bunch of solid improvements that should make your day-to-day a little easier. Thanks for watching and see you next month.
No, it's visible. The mic's not covering it up.